Hey there. I've had a lot of people on Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook ask for a full review of this Arrow Chute that we had rented for AIing the cows. So I'm going to go ahead and do a full review on that today. I was just going to post a short little clip on Instagram, but like I say, so many people have asked on all the platforms for a full review that that's what we're going to do right now. So if you're interested in my thoughts on the Arrow Tub Alley Chute portable combination, stick around. That's coming up right after this. Hey there, thanks for turning down my road. If this is your first time here, my name's Carl. My little brother and I both work for local farmers full time, but we both also farm together with our cattle herd and our hay operation. Everybody's involved, from the smallest to the biggest. If you don't have the joy of farming yourself, I'd love to help you experience it through this channel. Whatever your background, you found the right place. This is Dodge Brothers Farm and Ranch. Okay, as promised, I'm gonna talk a little bit about some of the stuff that I love about this chute and some of the stuff that we didn't really love about this chute. First of all, everything is really easy to adjust. This lever right here, all you gotta do is grab a hold of it, opens and closes the squeeze on the chute, and you can squeeze it all the way down to like 8 inches or something crazy small like that. The head gate can be operated anywhere you want. You can slide this control all the way up to the front and operate it right here next to the head gate, or you can slide it to the rear, which is especially nice if you're working cattle by yourself, because you can control the gate that lets them into the chute, and you can control the head chute at the same time from the same place. That's really cool. These gates right here, you just flip these little things up here and they open, and if you want to take them off, lift them up and they drop right out. Another thing that's kind of cool, we have a neck access bar right here. I don't know if we're gonna be able to see it very good because of the sun. Let's show you the one on the other side. So on both sides, you can just flip this out of the way right here. Gives you access to give the cows shots in their necks. The head holder, you just pull this lever down and it kind of controls their head so they can't thrash up and down. Really, really like this too. I also like how quiet everything is. And there's no extra latches to grab a hold of to release things, because the friction latch holds onto it until you just move the lever the other way. And when you start moving the lever the other way, it pushes up on this bolt and releases the friction latch. That's the same way that the head gate works. It's just move the lever one way or the other. You can also control those gates into the different parts of the chute from both sides. There's a lever over here to run these gates, and then there's that bar that sticks out the other side. So no matter what side of the chute you're on, you can control the flow of the cattle. You can get into the pout cage from either side, and the gates swing out or in, whichever way works best for you. And these pins are actually coated in plastic. So listen to how quiet this is. That's really quiet. I do like that. Both sides of the chute actually open up like this all the way, or you can make these two pieces operate separately if you want to open the top or the bottom independently. I like that. Like if you wanted to swing the bottom open or something and have a calf nursing. You've also got this rump bar to stick behind them and kind of keep working them up. These little plastic fingers work really good for sliding the rump bar up real quick, and they're quiet. You know, they don't make a whole lot of noise when you're moving the rump bar through. This section of the alley is adjustable. You just grab this rope, pull on it, and it pulls both pins out at once. You can adjust it to whatever width you want to. You can do it with one hand even if you want, if you only got one hand free. I like that. You've got your second door back here to get in and out of the tub to let cows in, and then to stop them from backing back into the tub. There is a gate, a sort gate right here. If you want to let somebody out of the tub and you can't go back that way, you can let them go this way. Like I say, all this stuff is pretty quiet. I think this is a standard 8-foot tub. It's got the spring-loaded lever over here to control to keep the tub from opening back up. This chute does have a folding tub, so all three sections of the tub are gonna fold up on each other and then come clear up against here. And then the chute is only, it ends here when you're pulling it down the road. So it takes 8 feet off the length of it, and it's really narrow when you're going down the road. Those are the things that I love about this chute. Let me show you the things that I do not like at all about this chute. So when you raise and lower it to put the wheels on, there's a big jack on both sides, just like this one. They're connected at the top by a drive shaft that goes across, and then it's controlled by a chain drive and a crank on the other side. Let's go look at that quick. So here's how you raise and lower the chute, by cranking this jack handle, and then both jacks go up and down at the same time. So if I want to start raising the chute up to put it in the transport position, I just turn the handle this way and we're running both jacks at the same time. Now the reason I don't like it is I counted and you have to turn the handle over 200 times to raise the chute enough to put the wheels back on. And then you got to turn it back another 200 times to raise the jacks into the up position to go down the road. That's a lot of cranking on the handle. I've talked to some people who have actually made a little adapter to put a big electric drill on here, and that would be a lot faster way to do it. I could see that working pretty slick. I don't really know what the answer to this problem is, because with the folding tub, you can't fold the tub out with your tire right here in the way. So you have to get the whole thing up and down together. You can't let one side down before the other, or you're gonna tip it over. So I understand why they need to run both jacks at the same time. I would love to see like a 2-speed jack on here like you would have on the landing gear on a semi-trailer. So at least when you're going down, or when you're just raising the jacks into the stow position, you could jack it really fast. Just not a whole lot of cranks, maybe 40 cranks to get it up instead of 200. I would love that. The other thing that we did not like, the folding tub. We've used a non-folding tub on an arrow chute before, and I'm pretty sure, I would have to measure, but in my mind, I'm pretty sure the tub is taller than this. This tub has to fold underneath the main frame on the top of the chute to go down the road. So it has to not be much taller than this. But we actually had a cow try to bail over this while we were working on the other day. And since the sheeting ends right here at about 3 feet, she was able to get her feet in here and just climb right up this thing. And she pretty much turned the whole chute sideways by pushing on the tub. I thought she was gonna get out. So this needs to be higher, and maybe the way to do that would be to have another bar like this. These support bars just fold in for transport. To have a way to drop another bar into here, a curved bar that would go around and hook into this loop, and the same around the back, to make the tub higher after you've got it folded out. Those are really the only two complaints I would have about the chute. Other than that, man, it's a really versatile piece of equipment. We enjoyed using it. I'm not getting paid to say any of this stuff. I just kind of wanted to show you this thing and tell you our experience about it. So that's it. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. So we've been needing to buy ourselves a good chute for a long time now. We've just been getting by with a kind of a rickety old headgate in the barn with a homemade alleyway that I built myself. The alleyway is really good. It's built out of guardrail, but the headgate is not good at all. And the pseudo chute that I built in there is also not good at all. So we need to buy something that we can use safely for the cows and safely for us to keep from getting hurt when we're working cattle. It's just not worth messing around with cheap old rundown equipment when you're trying to work cattle in a safe, effective manner. So like I say, we're looking at buying something. I'm not sure if we're going to buy one of these arrow chutes. We've also been looking at some Foremost chutes. I've also seen some Palco Stronghold chutes that I like. What are your thoughts? If you guys have a chute that you really like and a reason why, I'd love to hear about it. Drop me a comment in the comments section. Reach out to me on Facebook or Instagram and let me know your thoughts. I'd love to know what you're using and what you think of it. We should be making a decision here pretty soon, but I want to make sure I get something we're really going to like. Hey, I hope you enjoyed this little review video today, and I really hope you'll be back next week, because like I said last week, I'm excited about what I'm going to have in the video next week, as long as everything goes to plan. So, thanks for hanging out today. I'll see you next time.